during the speeches there. You'll be glad to know mine's is not quite as emotional. It's great to see so many fresh faces and familiar faces. Shout out the lads from Stag Do. So hey, what a weekend. An eclectic bunch of absolute gents. And that just goes to reflect Nairn as an individual. But for those who don't know me, my name is Paul, and it's an honour to be co-best man alongside Fraser today. He's done a remarkable job with embarrassing childhood stories, and I'll cover the late teen years onwards. But before I get into that, before I get to the speech, or as I like to call it, the roast of Nairn Mani, I'd just like to echo Fraser's sentiments. It has been a fantastic day. It's great that we can all come together and celebrate and share with the guys. Everyone's looking exceptional today, especially the star of the show. Give it up for your beautiful bride, Fee. And of course, the bridesmaids, Kat and Tanya. So I'll run through this and then we can all get into the party atmosphere. All right? And as a matter of fact, I'm looking forward to seeing everyone's best dance moves. If you've never seen Nairn dancing before, you're in for a special treat. It's spectacular. How would I describe it? Well, it's somewhere between a stiff sportsman and a flamboyant 80s pop star. So, somewhere between Andy Murray and Rick Astley. They're gonna give you, they're gonna let you down. All right, let's do this. Okay, so let's go back to 2006 when I met this weird and wonderful character. We are about 18, 19. First year of uni, first year of art school, and, you know, usually when you meet a person for the first time, right, you have a first impression. But when I met Nairn, I had about a million at once. There's too many to mention, but I'll mention a couple. The first thing, of course, was the hair. The magnificent Marnie Mane, the illustrious Auburn bouffant. And I have to say, mate, 16 years on, it's looking just as good as ever. I wish I could say the same. The second thing I noticed was I have never in my life seen a 19-year-old wearing a cardigan before. And I thought, we are dealing with quite the tricky customer. So a few years pass, and we head off to Australia. Whoosh, gap year, here we come. Right. We do the usual backpacker stuff. We see a couple of dolphins, stay in the hostels, all that sort of thing, right? You don't want to hear about that. Let me tell you about the time we went to Manly Beach. Do you remember now? Right, first of all, I don't know what we were thinking. Two pale Scottish lads on the ginger spectrum going to one of the most hot and humid countries imaginable. What were we thinking?
Everyone was beautiful.
Yes. So, everyone was beautiful, you're right. So, we hung out on the beach the whole day. 42 degrees. Outrageously humid, and it was full of like muscle-bound surfer dudes and bronze bikini babes. So we go out for the evening. We find this bar on the beach, sunset. It was beautiful, right? Where are we? Yeah. Sunset, the music, the vibe was popping off. Paradise, right? We are surrounded by Barbie and Kens. Barbie and Kens everywhere, right? Picture the scene, we are in this bar. Barbie and Ken. Two Scottish lobsters having a pint. The factory was called Manly Beach just as until then. And if you ever make out there, please.
SPF.
Please.
All right.
I've seen Nairn grow and transition through many phases and chapters in the last 16 years. I'll run you through them. I'll give you a quick whistle stop tour. Phase one, indie art school upstart. Hey, have you heard that new Arctic Monkey song? It's rubbish. Do you like the Plimsolls, the Fred Perry? Fred Perry, actually. Phase two, bohemian backpacking adventurer. Hey man, I'm gonna skate down to the soup kitchen and help out, dude. I just wanna float around and be free. Phase three, trendy London hipster. Can I have an oat cappuccino to go with an extra hazelnut shot, please? Do you like my cardigan? It's cashmere. To more recently, a distinguished Oxford gent, who's more worried about the political landscape, mortgage rates, and chasing Ronnie around the park. Yeah, and as you know, Ronnie's the family dog. It's not a new mate he's met up in Oxford. But all that aside, many chapters, many phases, I've never seen him as happy and at home than he has been since meeting Fee. And I remember 7 years ago when he told me he had a hot date coming up with a psychology student called Fiona. Ooh, come on, guys. So catch up with him afterwards, right? All right, mate, how'd you get on? What happened? Tell me about it. Ah, what happened?
Oh, excited, right? And he's like,
yeah, mate, not bad, yeah. We went for pizza and cocktails around King's Cross, yeah. Right. He was trying to play it cool, but I could tell he was buzzing. And because I know him, well, actually, that's the thing with him. He doesn't like to get too carried away with anything, unless it's like a full tin of chocolate biscuits or something. But because I know him, that call actually translates to, it was an absolute home run. And as they say, ladies and gentlemen, the rest is history. And I think we can all agree that Fee and Nairn complement each other incredibly well.
So,
Nairn, you leave here today with a kind-hearted, intelligent, generous, Oxford-educated doctor of psychology, an all-round lovely individual, and Fee. I guess it's true what they say. Opposites really do. Oh, I was going to say he's a fashionable guy, but the last 4 times I've seen him, he's been wearing an anorak and hiking boots. Every time I see him now, he looks like he's about to tackle Ben Nevis.
Dog and baby like.
Exactly, man, yeah. All right, so moving on. I think you can tell at this point, Nairn's a very multifaceted individual. On the one hand, most people, I'd say, know him as a friendly, affable chap who wouldn't hurt a fly. I would say most people know him this way, right? But on the other hand, there's people who have played football with him. And I think there's a few here who's played, so you know what I'm about to say, right? So, he's a keen footballer. And by keen, I mean he's incredibly enthusiastic, he will never let you down. And he plays exactly like Roy Keane. Roy Keane, the most aggressive midfield destroyer of all time. You'll never believe it, but it's amazing. Just to illustrate this point, when Fee and Nairn moved to Oxford a few years ago, he was craving a match with the London gang, so he arranged to play. And just to substantiate the Roy Keane claims, I have here in my hand the confirmation email from our mate Jordan who runs the football. Nairn's making a comeback, all right? Here's the email. Right, lads, we've got 10 for tomorrow night. Just a heads up, Nairn's in town. And making a guest appearance. Please remember to bring your shin guards, gum shields, crash helmets, and any other such protection. It's in your best interest. It's quite remarkable, really. So, you know, when we play five-a-sides, sometimes we're on the same team, sometimes we're on different teams. And I have to say, in football in terms and in life, I'd much rather be on his team. It's not just because those tackles are wild. And you know, you can tell a lot about someone's character on the pitch, and having shared the pitch with him many, many times, I could say for sure that he has a big heart, he wears it proudly on his sleeve, he's fiercely loyal, and he would also run through a brick wall for you. And sometimes he does. Sometimes he does. If you're ever around Finsbury Park with the football cages, you'll see a couple of Nairn-shaped holes in them. So if he ever invites you for a friendly game, just beware. Just be careful. All right. Just one quick card to go. And I can relax. Right, over the years, our mates have took the mick out of us constantly for many things, but one of them is they refer to us as Jack and Victor. Right, so Jack and Victor, for anyone who doesn't know, are two Scottish pensioners from a sitcom called Still Game. And just a little side note, if you've never seen it, it's on Netflix, you should check it out, it's pretty funny. They get caught up in all sorts of daft mishaps and scrapes. But can anyone guess who knows the show? Who's Jack and who's Victor in this scenario? Can anyone guess who's Jack and who's Victor? Well, luckily, I have some Wikipedia character descriptions here to help. So Jack Jarvis Esquire. A plucky patter merchant and happy-go-lucky chap. A popular member of the Craigland community, known around town for his witty comebacks and is partial to a beer or five. Okay. Now, Victor McDade. A tall cardigan-wearing man. Often found at home watching his favourite show, Bargain Hunt. A proud Scotsman whose favourite pastimes include collected antiques, eating tonics caramels, and drinking tea by the gallon. So for those friends who called us Jack and Victor, you obviously don't know us at all. From those last stories, you can tell we're a couple of rock and rollers. We're not pensioners, come on. Well, ladies and gentlemen, like all good double acts, over the years, there's been many funny moments, hairy moments, and even the occasional sketchy moment. But nevertheless, I'm sure like Jack and Victor, we'll remain lifelong pals. And that's about plenty from me, but just before I close and head straight to that bar, I would just like to say, as Fi and Nairn embark on their journey together with their baby boy Morris and their furry faced companion, Ronnie the Bedlington Rocket, you know, we all know, guys, that you're the absolute real deal. We wish you all the happiness and success in the world. So ladies and gentlemen, you can raise a glass for the happy couple to Fi and Nairn. See you on the dance floor.
Yeah.